She tells me a wrong-way driver caused that crash. She's expected to be okay, but she has been cited for impaired driving. Her passenger is in the hospital fighting to stay alive.
Our biggest message here is just to be smart.
By late Sunday morning, traffic was moving smoothly on the west belt of Interstate 215. Just hours earlier, this was the scene. UHP says that mangled Subaru was driving the wrong way and hit a large semi-truck. The impact caused a fire. UHP believes the driver of the Subaru was impaired, and both the driver and her passenger were not wearing seatbelts.
We have been seeing a major uptick in these lately, also an extreme rise in both DUI driving, DUI arrests.
Just 1 week ago, a child died in this crash in Sevier County. UHP said the driver of the SUV was intoxicated and driving the wrong way on Interstate 70. So far in 2022, 11 people have died in crashes on Utah roads. Last year, that number was 320, the worst since 2002. According to Zero Fatalities Utah, more than a third of those deaths happened in crashes involving impaired drivers. Another 76 were not wearing seatbelts. In most cases, lives that could have been saved if drivers made better decisions.
If you have to try to convince yourself that you can make it to the next exit or that you can get to a location that you think you need to try to get to, don't drive. It's not worth it.
The new year is young, and these trends can be stopped. Utah Highway Patrol believes it'll take a team effort for that to happen.
We're out enforcing as much as we can on that, but the only way we'll even come close to keeping the public safe is if they take some action in their own hands, and just it's time for them to take some initiative on their own part and help by wearing their seatbelt and then also just not driving impaired.
Early data from this year shows so far in 2022, alcohol has been suspected in some 63 crashes and drug use in another 27. In Murray, John Franke, Fox 13 News, Utah.